to HCN Evening News Bulletin with me, Clinton D'Souza, and here are the top stories. With the Supreme Court paving the way for the end of mining leases, brings control by the big mining barons. Thoughts have now turned into the mining dependents. They are not aware of the plans to have a government-controlled mining corporation. All they want is mining restart to improve the economic condition. Take a look.
काल आमची पिटिशन फायल उडयली भायर कोर्टांतल्यान सुप्रीम कोर्टांतल्यान आनी हो मायनींग जो बिजनेस आसा पळय हो गोंयचो मेन बिजनेस आनी तेज्या वांगडा आमकां ट्युरिजम आनी मायनींग आसा पळय तेजे सपोर्टाचेर हे गोंय चलताले. आतां ट्युरिजमूय बंद मायनींगूय बंद आनी आमी जगपाचे कशे? आमच्या कडेन चाराणें आसचें ना फुडें जगतले जाल्यार. आमी आतां हांगाच्यान भुरगे वयताले खंय ट्युरिजमाक कामाक वयताले कसो ते सायडीन मायनींग बंद जाल्यार टॅक्सी चलून मायनींग करता टॅक्सी बंद सगळोच बंद जाल्यार भुरगे कितें म्हणून करतले? मायनींग बंदूच तेंच्यांनी केल्यो आसा करतले कितें म्हणून आमी. आनी ह्या एड्युकेशनाचेर आमकां मायनींगाचो खूब फायदो आसलो. एम्बुलंस फुकट मेळटाली आमकां कंपनीची, प्लस आमकां एड्युकेशनल भुरग्यांक बस मेळटाली, शिक्षणाक भुरग्यांक बुकां गावतालीं, वेदांता दिताली कंपनी, गीतावाला पारुलेकर दिताली आमकां कंपनी, आरे शेट्टी दिताली, हेल्प करताली आमकां सगळ्यांक मायनींग वेल्डा मायनींग वेल्डाच्या लोकांक. पण हांव तुका सांगता आमकां जर हे जर आतां मायनींग बंद करून आमकां फुडें तो विचार कसो? आमची चवथ, आमी भुरगे मनीस, आमी खंय वयतले? ट्रक घरा कडेन धरून करतले कितें? ट्रक आतां एक काम करपाचे गव्हर्मेंटान, ट्रक आपल्या घरा कडेन व्हरोन सीएमान धरचो. कित्याक आमच्या कडेन ट्रक चलोवपाची काय कॅपेसिटी ना, कित्याक आमी ट्रकांक बसूंक बी शकना. सीएमान अशें चिंतपाचें की ट्रक व्हरून आपल्या घरा कडेन दवरचो आनी सीएमान तो ट्रक चलोवचो, कित्याक ताका जाय जाल्यार. कित्याक आमी घरा कडेन धरून करतले म्हणून कितें? हे ट्रकाचो ट्रकाचो आमकां कितेंच फायदो ना. ट्रक आमी कांयच करूंक शकना ट्रकाचे. स्क्रॅपाक दिवन म्हणून कितले वते? 2 लाखांनी बँकेचे पयशे कितले भरतले? आमी सगळ्यांनी आमच्यो वस्ती धरल्यो, घाण आनी कितें धरून आमी ज्यो गाडयो रेडी करता, पासींग करता, आनी पासींग करूनच जर तुमी आमच्यो गाडयो बंद करतात.
म्हाका धंदो करून कितलीशीं वर्सां जालीं, तेन्ना मायनी चालू आसल्यो म्हणून हांवें धंदो चालू केल्लो. पूण मायनी जेन्ना पळय बंद जाल्यो तेन्ना धंदो सामको डावन पडलो आनी बँकेचो हांवें लोन काडलें आनी एक ट्रक घेतलो. ट्रक घेतना मायनी सगळ्यो बंद जाल्यो, बंद जाल्यो आनी बँकेचे आमकां लोन काडलेले पळय ते बँकवाले सगळे येयले आनी म्हणाले तूं लोन फारीक करूंक जाय. पूण म्हाज्या कडेन लोन फारीक करपाक जायना जालें, तेन्ना बँकेन आमकां हें काडली ते लोन फारीक करूंकूच जाय म्हण. तरी आसतना आमी लोन हेजे तेजे वस्ती घाण दवरल्यो आनी कितें केलें आनी लोन काडलें तें फारीक केलें. एकदां गाडी आमी सोडली आनी आतां जर पळयत जाल्यार मायनी सगळ्यो बंद जाल्ल्यो आसा आनी आमी आमची इतली पोटाची अशी हें जाल्ली आसा की आतां कितें करपाचें? आमी आतां कितें करचें? बायलां भुरग्यांक पोसतलो कशी अशी आमची परिस्थिती जाल्ली आसा. तेन्ना आतां सरकारान म्हणटा ती ताबडतोब मायनी चालू करच्यो आनी आमचें कितें पोटाचें तुमी पळोवपाचें. इतलीच हांव सरकारा कडेन विनंती करतां की ताबडतोब मायनी चालू करच्यो अशीच हांव तेंच्या कडेन मागणी मागतां.
We are joined by Claude Alvarez of the Goa Foundation, the person who has led the decade-old, in fact, more than a decade-old struggle to ensure that illegal mining stops in Goa and a more sustainable environment is in place. Claude, what is your immediate reaction to the final challenge in the Supreme Court being dismissed and the court saying that the 88 leases that were renewed the renewal was illegal and they upheld the decision to scrap those leases?
Well, I think it's a great victory coming after many years of very hard work, but it's something to which we have not contributed as far as the review petitions are concerned, because normally the review petitions are filed by somebody who has an objection to the judgment. And in this case, it was the judgment of a 2-judge bench of the Supreme Court, which was passed on the 7th of February, 2018. Both the Goa government and Vedanta company filed their objections to this judgment. And we really didn't do anything as far as this was concerned, because review petitions normally go before a bench of the Supreme Court. And generally they go before the same bench that passed the judgment that is sought to be reviewed. But in this case, both the government and Vedanta waited till both the judges retired from the bench and then approached the Supreme Court. And that is what the Supreme Court has basically been very critical about. They said that this affects the sanctity of Supreme Court decisions. We can't allow this. We can't allow people to come and challenge considered judgments at any time. If they had some problem, they should have come within 30 days. They are coming after 650 days, which is totally unacceptable.
But the Supreme Court also has said that they are rejecting the review petition on grounds of merit as well.
Yes, they have been very careful to say that they have looked at the review petitions and not found any grounds for reviewing the judgment of Justice Lokur and Justice Deepak Gupta. They have been very categorical about it. But more important is right now, they have completely brought down the entire mining industry in a very permanent way, because as long as these review petitions were pending before the Supreme Court, the state government could claim that they need not do any and take any action because these petitions were pending. But now that the challenge to Justice Lokur's judgment is finally thrown out by the Supreme Court, this sounds the death knell of the private mining industry in the state of Goa, that the watchman we have placed to watch over these goods themselves began to participate with the thieves to ensure that these goods were stolen. And that is why we have reached a stage where the Goa government, having realized the benefits they get from illegal mining, was now loath to cut and sever the links with these miners, because these miners were very brazen in their mining operations. They knew that they had to only manage a few individuals in the government, in the mines department, etc., and they could walk away with crores of money which they got from pilfering these resources, with the authorities simply looking the other way. As a matter of fact, the Justice Shah Commission report explicitly records that during the time when Digambar Kamath was the chief minister of the state of Goa, the officers of the mines department were expressly directed not to visit the mining areas and not to interfere with what was going on there.
Claude, coming to the Shah Commission report, which was going to be my next question, actually. The amount of loss was pegged at that point of time at 35,000 crores, though the figure was approximate. Now, obviously, in spite of the best efforts of yours and the entire agitation that took place to recover the mining loot, that has never been recovered. Now, is there a way in which that money can be recovered? And if that money comes back, how do we benefit? And can it come back?
See, the money can come back if the Goa government has got the will to get that money back, because all these mining companies have assets. They have assets in banks, they have assets in buildings, then they have numerous other assets which can be seized and impounded so that the money can be recovered from all the illegal mining that has taken place. It is only after we moved a writ petition in the High Court that the government conceded that they had to recover these amounts. And you will be surprised to note that out of this 3,000 plus crores which they are supposed to recover, they have now come up with a lame excuse that they can only recover some 300 crores.
What was this recovery against Claude? What was this recovery for?
See, when the mining was shut down because of all the illegal operations, which was actually documented by the former Chief Minister Manohar Parrikar when he was Chief Minister of the state and when he was Chairman of the Public Accounts Committee, he had estimated that a large amount of ore had been stolen, and his committee actually came to the conclusion that more than 3,500 crores had been stolen. Then what he did was he appointed a very high committee of chartered accountants, about 17 or 18 chartered accountants. It's known as the Chartered Accountants Committee. And this Chartered Accountants Committee then asked for the accounts and the figures from the Department of Mines and from the mining companies. And it came to the conclusion that the mining companies actually owed the Goa government some 1,500 crores, which had to be recovered. And the Goa government actually issued notices for these amounts for recovery. But they did nothing till we went to the court. This was one item of recovery as per the report of the of the Chartered Accountants Committee. But there was another report which came out, which is from the Comptroller and Auditor General of India, their 2016 report, which estimated that a sum of 2,500 crores had to be recovered from mining companies on various accounts, including non-payment of royalty, etc., etc., and based on which the state government had also issued demand notices. But they had done nothing. So we went to the High Court even for that, to recover even that amount. And the High Court issued notice, and the government conceded that they had to recall those amounts from the mining companies. But till date, they have done nothing in respect of recovery of those amounts. So a total amount of 3,431 crores, for which the government itself have issued notices for recovery from mining companies, is still lying unclaimed, unrecovered. And the government is now pretending that they can only claim a mere 300 crores on those notices. This is the state of Goa today.
Chief Minister, after coming back from Delhi and after the order, said that the future of mining lies in having a mining corporation as well as auctions. My point is, don't you think auctions will allow the same people and people from outside, the tycoons, to get back through a back route? And what is your view on a mining corporation where it's going to be controlled completely by the government?
Well, we have already written to the Goa government on several occasions, even when Mr. Parikar was alive and he had asked us to send our proposals. We have also sent these proposals to Dr. Pramod Sawant. We have said very clearly, please set up the corporation and please do mining only under the auspices of a public sector corporation. We have had several reasons for doing this, because if it's with the corporation, then it's very difficult for outside people to come in and bid. Because if you have auctions, then you can be sure that very powerful actors are going to come from outside the state and bid for these auctions and walk away with the wealth that is there under the ground as far as Goa is concerned. So we said, go in for a corporation, and it's going to be easier for you to restart mining if you go in for a corporation. And most important is, we can watch a corporation. There's a CAG to watch a public corporation. We can monitor how much is removed. We can monitor theft in a corporation very well. And most important also, the incentive to steal goes out in a corporation, because the corporation can give out the contracts to extract the ore, and then the ore can be collected by the corporation and sold in the international market or the Indian market. And all that money can go directly into a permanent fund. And the Goans can then be paid a basic income from the interest of this money. Every citizen from the state of Goa can be given a basic income for the rest of their lives from this money.
Commuting on Pato Bridge can be dangerous. If not repaired, you might find yourself in the middle of the Mandu River. The Pato Bridge needs immediate repairs, which, and the fence of this bridge has developed cracks. You may never know when commuters would end up swimming in the Mandu River. Abhijit Jadhav reports this.
आणि आता इतले गॅप पडला नो एक स्कूटर जर ओव्हरटेक जर एका गाडी जर करून दिला झपकून एका साईडी घेऊन पडू शकता येदे वडले गॅप पडलेले असा एक कारण किती नो की हे जे काम फाटल्या दिसांनी आमचो बाप मनोहर पर्रिकर जेव्हा असले त्यांना इफ्फी जेव्हा गोयात पहिलीच हाडलेले आणि लाखांनी आणि कोट्यांनी जे पैसे मोडलेले त्यांना बेगीन बेगीन जी कामं करता सरकार आपणाक उजगाडानं करपाक जाय खंयचो CM असलो काय ना त्याची जर कारकिर्दी सोंपता त्यांना त्यांना जर लास्ट मिनटात जर बेगीन बेगीन कामं करपाक जाय जाल्यार बेगीन बेगीन यांच्यानी कामं करपाची असता आणि बेगीन बेगीन कामं करतात आणि रिझल्ट किती आता फायनली आयज हो प्रश्न झालेलो असा एक व्हडलो क्रॅक पडलेलो असा पण BJP सरकारान खंयचो जावं BJP सरकार जावं आणि खंयचो मिनिस्टर जावं खंयचो आमदार जावं खंयच्या गव्हर्नमेंटाचो जावं पण आयज प्रॅक्टिकली उलोवंक गेले जाल्यार एक न्युट्रल उलोवंक गेले जाल्यार हे सरकार आज जी कामा करता ये मनोहर पर्रिकरान काम के पाटो पुल ये हो पुल नासलो तेना ये सरकार जी एस आई डी सी जे आसा गोवा स्टेट इन्फ्रास्ट्रक्चर डेवलपमेंट कॉर्पोरेशन जे आ खाते जे आसा ऑथॉरिटी जे आसा ये खुंसरूच तेंचो इंजिनियर सारको काम करिना खंयचो तेजो जो कन्सल्टंट सारको काम करिना कॉन्ट्रेक्टर सारको काम करिना बेभरोशाची कामां करता न्ही हे आपली नांवां येवपाक बीजेपी सरकारान बेगीन बेगीन कामां केल्या हें उदाहरण म्हणजे एक हांगा एक सर्कस जावं शकता कोणाची हितूंतलो जर भुरगो जर ल्हान भुरगो जर वयता हांगा स्कुटरीन तेजो पप्पा जर वयता आनी भुरगो जर फुडें मोटरसायकलीचेर किंवां स्कुटरीचेर उबो रावलो आनी एका गाडयेक ओवरटेक करून जाय हे सायडीक जर टर्न मारलो हे सायडीक जर मारले जाल्यार गाडी ही भितर पळोवन व्हडलो अपघात जावं शकता हेका लागून हे जे काम जे केल्लेले आसा आनी अशी बेगीन बेगीन जी कामां करता सरकार ही सरकार अशी बेगीन बेगीन काँक्रिटाची तरी कामां अशी करपाची ना सेपरेट जाता आसतना हेका आतां सरकार परत आतां फाल्यां हळूहळू व्हडले गॅप पडटले आनी हेका पावसान 8 दीस कंटिन्युअस जर पावस पडलो परिस्थिती अशी जर जाता हे आमचे सरकार नेचरा कडेन जर खेळता न्ही आयज नेचर हो तुमकां आयज दाखयता स्वभाव दाखयता आपलो नेचर म्हणजे कितें तें काँक्रीट जे आसता न्ही काँक्रिटाचो शब्द वेगळो आसता आनी नेचराचो शब्द वेगळो आसता ह्या सरकारान असली कामां अख्ख्या गोंयांत केलेली आसा आनी अशी कामां पळोवंक गेले जाल्यार सोदूंक गेले जाल्यार अख्ख्या गोंयांत हे सरकाराचे भ्रश्ट सरकाराची ही कामां आमकां पळोवंक दिसता प्रत्येक गोंयकाराक हांव वयता आसतना मागता हांगासून हे सायडीसून गोवर्मेंटान बेगींतल्या बेगीन हांगा बॅरिकेड करपाचे हे सायडीक आनी हांगा कितें तरी प्रोविजन करपाचें कित्याक लागून आमची गोंयची जनता हांगासून येता वयता कोणाकूच धोका जायत जाल्यार बीजेपीचो सरकार आनी पीडब्ल्यूडी आनी जी एस आय डी सी जे आसा हेका जबाबदार आसता म्हणून मागता हो जो स्पॅन जो आसा न्ही कमीत कमी 300 मिटर आसा हे गॅप जे आसा न्हू हे गॅप कमी कमी 35-35 मिटर सुमार आसा पळोवंक गेले जाल्यार 300-350 मिटर हांगासून गॅपाक हे व्हडले स्ट्रेच पडलेलो आसा हो खरोखरच मागता हांव गोंयच्या जनते कडेन हेजेर तरी हेजेर भेदभाव करूं नाका तुमी गोंयच्या जनते कडेन खेळो नाका बेगीतले बेगीन हेजेर कितें तरी बॅरिकेड करा हांगा पुलिसांक सांगात जाल्यार कोण तरी पोलीस तरी दवरा कित्याक हांगा एक सायडीक जर कोणाक जर दवरीत जाल्यार बरें पडटलें आनी बॅरिकेड केल्या उपरांत कमीत कमी प्रत्येक जनता हांगासून वयताना अख्खे गोंयचे जनते खातीर हांगा सायडीक वयता आसतना प्रत्येकान आपली जिवाची काळजी घेयात कारण हो सरकार फक्त रोग हाडपाक तयार आसा वॅक्सीन मारपाक तयार आसा पूण अशे गोश्टीक इंजेक्शन मारूंक जाल्यार कामां जावचीं ना कोण मेलेलो आमकां मेळचो ना आयज 3,100 लोक मेलेले आहा बेपरवायेचे सरकार आहे जबाबदारीचे सरकार न्ही मागता गोंयच्या जनते कडेन बेगीनले बेगीन हे काम करपाचे म्हणून मागता
Eid al-Adha is one of the most important days in the Islamic calendar. On this day, people visit their families, friends, and celebrate the festival with gifts, greetings, hugs, and spreading love. With the pandemic raging still, the festival was celebrated with proper measures, keeping social distancing in mind. Watch this edit celebrations in this story.
हम लास्ट 2 ईयर से घर में ईद बना रहे क्योंकि सबको पता है बाहर पैंडेमिक कोरोना वो सब चल रहा है तो पहले तो हम कारवार जाते थे यहाँ से हमारा नेटिव प्लेस है उधर हम सबके घर जाते थे शिरकुरमा खाते थे और ईद ही लेते थे तो उसमें बहुत मज़ा आता था हम मतलब फ्रेंड्स की ग्रुप बना के जाते थे और सबसे ईद मुबारक करते थे मिलते थे सबको भी खुशी होती थी और सब खुश भी हो जाते थे कि हाँ ये अच्छा है मेरे को मिला आके ऐसा तो अभी ये 2 साल से तो हम घर में ही बना रहे हैं लेकिन हम अल्लाह से दुआ करते हैं कि ये दिन फिर से जल्दी आ जाए और सब लोग अपने साथ एक साथ ईद मनाएं
हम लोग अभी ये 2 साल से हम लोग घर में ईद बना रहे हैं अभी हमको बाहर नहीं जाने मिल रहा किसके घर को नहीं जाने मिल रहा सो हम लोग अभी ये सोच रहे हैं कभी हमारा बाहर जाने का सबके लोग के घर में आके बैठ के ईद भी बना के आने का तो भी मिलेगा सो जल्दी आया तो अच्छा है
पहले मैं अब्बा के साथ सबके घर जाते थे ईद बनाने बनने का भी कोरोना है तभी जानने बंद हो गया और अभी घर में बैठ के सबके सामने ईद बनाते हैं
पहले आप ईद कैसे मनाते थे
हाँ बहुत अच्छे मनाते थे ईद की बकरी ईद बोलकर मनाते थे हम लोगों को लड़ाई के खाना बना के लाते थे ऐसा सब
लोग आते जाते थे
आते जाते थे सब मिलते थे सबको हमारे में हाथ में मिलते हैं ना सब मिला सब करते
Hi, I'm Maliha. Happy Eid to everyone, all the families. I hope everyone is having a safe Eid. It's been almost 2 years. We are all at home with our families and have spent a quality time. But we also have to get back to our normal lives. Everybody is wishing for that. Everybody wants to go back to pavilion without the mask, going out with friends and everything. I hope that day comes soon. Until then, everybody should be taking their precautions and everything. And I hope everybody gets vaccinated soon.
Wish everyone happy Eid. Eid Mubarak to all of you. Be safe and at home only. Don't visit others unnecessarily. Wish Eid Mubarak.
Eid Mubarak to all. Eid Mubarak sabke liye hamare taraf se. This is the Eid second year. We are celebrating with our family. You all very well know due to COVID, this COVID pandemic situation, which I pray to Allah that it goes off soon and everybody is relieved from that. I pray to Allah that this COVID goes off and we are happy enough to celebrate Eid as usual how we were celebrating. To say, last year also we celebrated Eid at home, both Eid al-Zuha and Eid al-Fitr. Similarly, this year also we celebrated Eid al-Zuha and Eid al-Fitr at home only. But coincidentally, what has happened, our families have come together. Our family, my cousin, brother, all those are at home. We are celebrating Eid together. We couldn't go, our gents couldn't go to mosque because of the limitations and some rules, norms to be followed. But we prayed at home, namaz was done at home and cooking. It is like we have celebrating our Eid within four walls, which I pray that it shouldn't happen. But even in this disadvantageous stages, we are happy with our family and celebrating Eid in our house with good tasty food and with humorous environment and with entire family. I pray that this COVID goes off soon. We celebrate Eid like, as usual. We celebrate in masjid, go meet relatives. And because of COVID, we are avoiding meeting people, meeting relatives, so that they are safe and we are also safe enough. Hope, I pray, I request all the people to have safe and happy Eid.
While Goa will be witnessing heavy to heavy rainfall until the 23rd of July, the IMD has issued an orange alert. Fishermen are strictly advised not to venture the sea. Well, that's all we have in today's news bulletin. For updates, please do subscribe to our YouTube channel HCN Goa or follow us on Twitter and Facebook to stay alerted by following us at O Heraldo Goa. Until then, goodbye and take care.